But the night I was screaming, dreaming, always the Germans is running after me. They coming to trap me after me. When they took us away in the Holocaust in 1944, April, in the same week after Pesach, Hungarian police came in to us in the house, and they say like this, everybody from the house to go out. I was 20 years then. So we went out. My mother, she put on the umbrella by the eyes, the people not to look for her in the face, how she was crying. So they took us in the ghetto. It calls Dragomirisht. The end came an order. There's the ladies to bring for the men's the things like interwear and suits, everything. I went to my father and I want to give him the whole package. No, he said, Rochel, I don't need nothing. Just give me the talus and twillen. In a Hungarian police, so this I gave him the talus and twillen, and he came and he gave my father a kick, and the father loosed on the floor, the talus and twillen. He lay down to pick it back, and with this talus and twillen, my father went in the crematorium, holding like this, the talus and twill. And more, I didn't saw my father. So we was there 4 weeks in Dragomirisht. To end, they took us over the hill to the train, 3 days and 3 nights. And they took us away till Auschwitz. You never was in Auschwitz, no? I went down with my mother, straight by the hand, till the crematorium. The crematorium was a big, big house with 2 doors in the front. One door, when you went in, the ceiling, it was like here, only shouts. When the people was inside, in this room, came down showers. In the other door, when they went in, came gas. They had a big oven with fire. And I went with my mother by the hand. We didn't notice everything. We went straight in the room where the gas was. I stepped over by the door. I went in. So all of a sudden, I give a look on the left side. I see all youngsters going in the line. And near me, it was a friend. And then I said to my friend, her name was Suri. Suri, take a look. We're not allowed to stay here near the mothers. We have to run after the girls. So we was running like 2 blocks. Nobody stopped us. I say like this, Suri, Suri, take a look. I see outside my mother walking in with your mother. And one girl who was cleaning, she'd say like this, da mama is distort. Kick da mama. She show us this fire from the crematorium. Like this of the whole sky, we saw the fire. And then I lay down on the floor. Then I was crying. I never cried in the Holocaust. This was the first time and the last time. So my Seider, you know, he was 70 years. Yeah. And outside was the crematorium. Was a big fire, and they threw him in life and fire. It was there, the doctor, Mengele, you heard of him, yeah? He was choosing who is to live and who is to dead. We went through him naked, one year left another. And he had in the hand a stick for wood. He just made like this or like this, you understand? Who was wrong for work, they put you a number. 75-64. Why the number? Because if you were the work in the field and you run away, they should bring you back to the camp. When they put you the number, they cut you the hair. So I remember, I take a look in the window, I didn't recognize me. I turned the head. Who was behind me? It was me. You know, they took away the hair. I didn't recognize myself. They took us, and it was barracks. Inside it was wood. No pillow, no cover, no nothing. We was there from May 1944 till October in Auschwitz, in the same barracks. So we was on the train, the guard, they see it's coming a whole line with Russian airplane to bombard the train. And they run out from the train and we knock the door. We see this we going to be killed. So they didn't want us to be saved. They bring us to be killed. All for sort. I hear a knock. One aeroplane threw down a bomb off the roof from the train where of the same car where I was with 10 girls. And instead to fell in the roof, the bomb fell on the side. And Leipzig was a big stationary with soldiers. With Germans, they came and they opened the door for us. And then they opened the door. And they say like this, I will tell you in German how they say. And then I explain to you. Verfluchte Jude, du wirst lang, lang leben. You know what this means? You dirty Jews, you will be long in life. You know why I'm here in life? The Germans bless me. It was a blessing. It was a few days before end of the war. So they told us just to go dead march. Just to march. And they didn't give us food. After walking, they led us to sit in the street to rest. So the Germans was planting already vegetables, potatoes. So I had there a friend, a girl, her name was Yoli. She said to me like this, Ruchel, let's go on the other side to grab out some food. So she went on this side. She said to me, you go on this side. All of a sudden I hear a shot. A girl from our town was screaming, Ruchel, Ruchel, run away. Don't you see they shot Yoli? Then I turned the head. A German soldier came to me. Then I turned my head by the eyes and he held it straight like this to shot me. And the German wants to kill me. And he didn't do it. So this was God. God took care of me. And I'm here. So then I came home from the war. I had 6 brothers. So for 6 brothers remain alive, only 2. 4 got killed. The 2 brothers was in the house when I came home. Then soon came home the boy, which wants to go get married with me. He said this, he's going to his brother, if I want to go with him. Then I say like this, if you get married with me, I go with you. If not, I'm not going. So he say, okay, so come, I will get married with you. That's it. And we live together. I had 3 kids, 2 daughters and a son. One daughter died. She had ovarian cancer. How many grandchildren? Usually, let me tell you, you don't say from the children how many, because it's not healthy. When they ask me how many grandchildren, you know, about the JCC, I say, children, I don't count. I count just money. You know what they say, who came back from the Holocaust can give you a blessing. So I give you a blessing, you should have a sach mazel. Be well and live long.